Welcome back. We are going to continue to build out our bot that shorts what we might think is a Ponzi scheme. I'm not going to go ahead and say which coins or anything that I think is a Ponzi, but I'm going to build this bot with you. And then what's great is we can go ahead and set it live on anything that we do feel like is going to go down, down, and down forever. So I'm not here to make any accusations. I'm just here to build. This is my day to day. I build new bots every single day. So I think of new ideas, new trading strategies, and usually in the nighttime or throughout the day. And then in the morning, like now, I build them. Now, what's great about this is even if you don't know how to code, if you just watch this video, you'll start to learn. And just like you, maybe if you're not a coder, I wasn't a coder before either, but I knew that, hey, if I could turn my trading strategies into code, well, then everything would be executed automatically 24/7, 365, right? Without emotions. And that's like the best alpha I've ever been able to generate from the market is, hey, remove your emotions and everything gets better. So you can hear this note here. I mean, you can see this note here. We're shorting any crypto that I plug in. And then we check to see BTC. If it's above the 4-hour SMA, we're not going to do anything because that means that crypto in general is trending to the upside. And even if we think it's a Ponzi scheme or there's some coin that we think is going to go down and down, even if we think that, like, I don't really want to be shorting anything in that type of environment. But if it is, if Bitcoin is under the SMA, then we will aggressively short whatever crypto we do think is going to go down. So, of course, it's not going to be Bitcoin. I'm a big believer in Bitcoin, Ethereum, all that good stuff. That being said, I think there are some cryptos out there that do look like they're kind of set up like Ponzi schemes, and I want to short them. So I have my bot do it, and that's what we're building in this video. And I need to make sure to go ahead and get everything set up here so we can start rolling. I'm gonna set a bit of a timer here so we don't make this video too long, but let's just dive into it. And like I said, even if you're not a coder, stick with me because you'll be intimidated by the code, but don't worry, because I was too. Let's go ahead and move some of this stuff out of the way. And we left off in last video. This is where we paused. So we paused it, getting the deviation from the SMA to see how much leverage we can use. And what I mean by this is, essentially, we're trying to see like how high above the SMA in the past 10 days has the price gone. So here's the yellow line's the SMA, and for example, like, okay, it's gone 3% over. Well, okay, that will kind of determine how much leverage we can use. So if it's 5% over, that's the highest it's gone over the SMA. Well, that means we can use, you know, 5 times whatever that leverage is. So up to 20x leverage. I wouldn't ever use 20x leverage. I think that's too much, but it should be interesting to see. And we've made a lot of progress in this. This is a different bot that's running, so don't worry about what's going on down there. Like, don't worry too much. I mean, you can watch it for sure. We have a couple open positions, but this is my mean reversion bot that we built the other day here on YouTube. I built everything on YouTube so you can see it for free. If you ever want the code or you want like step-by-step tutorials on exactly how to be an algo trader and everything I know, there's the bootcamp link below. That bootcamp link is going to show you everything you need to know to algo trade, get from getting started to expert, whether you know how to code or not. There are so many different nuances within building bots and algo trading that I put together a training because so many people were asking me for it. Okay, cool. So now you know that. Links below. If you ever get confused or ever have any questions, please let me know. But all the code is in the bootcamp. So let's go ahead and pick up where we left off. We paused at trying to get the deviation, meaning how much higher does the price go from the SMA. And I started to think about it a bit, and I actually want to do this for the 4-hour. I think it's going to be safer than the 15-minute, and it will take less trades, sure, but I think it's just going to be safer. And now that I think about it, I actually might want to do it for the hour. Let's go ahead and let's go over here to BTC and let's pick a like an altcoin. Let's just say like I don't know. I don't want to like call any of these Ponzi schemes, and I don't want to make any inference because I don't, you know, I don't. This is my opinion. So I'm just picking a random one. Cardano. Let's see how high Cardano goes over the hour. 3.6. 8%, 9%. And then let's check the 4 hour. I think the 4 hour is great. I think the 4 hour is where we're gonna do this. It's gonna trade less because we're trading off the 4 hour, but that's not a bad problem to have because we can just sit in the shorts. Now, I wasn't saying Cardano was a Ponzi scheme, by the way. I was just picking a random chart. I'm making no accusations of any of these being Ponzi schemes. I'm just building this bot in order to, if I do identify a new coin that looks like a Ponzi, well, then I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna run this bot. So I built all my bots here for free on YouTube. If you do appreciate that transparency, please do go ahead and hit the like button. That tells me, hey, keep building with me. So I need to change some things up because I want to go ahead and do this on the 4 hour. So I'm gonna say 4 hour right there. This grabs my DFSMA, and then I'm gonna change this to 4, and I'm gonna change this to 4 hour. 4 hour. Hopefully this all just works. That would be awesome. Or else we'll have to do a little debugging. No problem. But we're gonna fly through this. So again, if you have any questions, just let me know below. And let's go ahead and print this DF. Let's see if it works. Ah, I should have made it bigger. Might have to run that back one more time. Okay, no key error. Where is that? 15 minutes. Okay, it's down there. Let's make those changes. Perfect. I needed to make it bigger anyways, so. Okay, here we go. So let's see how this looks. It says the signal is sell because the current price is less than the current SMA. You can't see the SMA, unfortunately. It's right in these dot, dot, dots. Now, the high versus the SMA is negative 0.6 or negative 6%. So that means that it never went over the SMA. So essentially what we want to find here is we want to find the high. So find the high of this column right here. So this column pretty much does the calculation that we went over that will get how much, like what's the deviation? How much percentage above the SMA did it get on this column or on this timestamp right here? And you can see these are every 4 hours. So 4, 4, 4. So it says the price or the high column, will never actually got over the SMA. And it is in fact minus 4.69% under the SMA. So we're looking for the high of this. So hopefully it's a positive number. And if we get that, so find the high of whatever that column's called. It's called this. And this equals our percent over SMA. Then we can find the amount of leverage we can use. Now, this is like not a perfect solution, but hey, you know, it's better than just saying, hey, we're gonna use 10x leverage. Because what if we're using 10x leverage, but over the past 30 days, there's been highs of 20% over the 4 hour SMA. Well, at 10x leverage, that's a liquidation, right? So that's why we're doing this. So let's go ahead and say biggest deviation. I'm gonna say biggest dev equals the high. So df dot whatever this is. It's this, right? That column. I want the high of that column. So I want dot max. And then I want to just say print. Looks like we're having a little error there. Oh, I see what's going on. Biggest deviation. And remember, this bot to the bottom right that's running is a different bot. It has nothing to do with this, you know, so this ticker is not like the one I'm gonna trade on, but this is our mean reversion bot that we built a couple days ago. So, okay, perfect. So we have the biggest deviation now. Let's see if that actually works. Let's get rid of some of these print statements to not confuse ourselves. Okay, so that's the biggest deviation. So max lev equals 100 divided by biggest deviation. And then let's print f. This is the max lev we can use. Max lev. Okay, so now we've figured out how much leverage we can use. And it should be here. So we can use 8.61 leverage, maximum. So I don't actually want to do that. I want to do about 90% of that. So max lev equals 0.9 times max lev. Okay, so now this should be 90% of that. So the reason I did that is because, okay, if this is the maximum, that's awesome, but I don't want to quite use all the way. So 7.75, let's actually do 80%, because let's just be a little more conservative. We don't, you know, if this works, it works. So who can, don't get greedy with the leverage, you know, in my opinion, at least. You know, I'm not here to make bajillion. Let's go ahead and make this an integer. Let's see what it pops out now. I think it'll just round up. I'm trying to think if that's going to be a good way to do it or not, though. I like that. It actually rounded down. I think it rounded down at least. Let's go ahead and check out float. I actually like if it rounds down. That makes me feel way more secure. Okay, perfect. It did round down. So if I have integer in here, it's going to round down. So 6x leverage. I like that. So let's say leverage equals that. Holy smokes, what did I do? So let's reassign leverage. Let's just get rid of this. And look at that, it's actually, it went to the exact leverage that I had written up there, like I've done this before or something. So let's just say leverage equals that, and then leverage equals that. Okay, now we run our leverage. So we know how much leverage we can use. And I like that, because it's conservative, or it's kind of conservative at least. Let's go ahead and flip this back over to our open positions just so we can see what's going on with the other bot while it's going. It's just a mean reversion bot that we built in the one of the last videos. Actually, it was a few videos. It was like two or three videos, a few hours actually. So you can always watch that if you want a mean reversion strategy that gets all 75 tickers on phemex. I also just uploaded all the code and a short video to the bootcamp too. So bootcamp's got everything you'll ever need. But also my YouTube has everything you'll ever need too. It just takes a little longer to go through things. So let's go ahead and see what else do we need to do. So we have the leverage. Let's just get rid of all of this, these prints. I'm really happy we did this because now we will never use too much leverage. And this leverage is very based off of exactly, you know, what the past has shown us. And I'm curious actually, what is the past? How long does it go back? Because we might have too many bars here. No, I think being conservative is good actually. So it doesn't matter how long the past is, I'm just curious now. So it goes all the way to 12, 11, 21, and today, so it's like 6 months. Nice. I like that. That makes me feel very secure. This is saying for this symbol that's as high as we can go. Let's go ahead and say print. This is the max leverage we can use. And then I want to test this with, let's just test it with another one. I'm just going to use ADA USD. I have nothing against ADA. I'm not saying that is the one I'm going to be using this on. It's here. I've got nothing wrong with it. Some people love it, some people hate it. I just want to stress test this and make sure it works. Perfect. So the max leverage we could use on ADA would be 4. Cool. It's good to know. Let's try it on another one. Let's see what symbols they have here. What about dot? Let's try dot. And I just want to make sure this is working for all, or not all, but you know, just kind of random test them. Okay, so 4. So cool. So it looks like a lot of the altcoins is going to be like about 4x leverage we can use. That's the past 1,000 days or 3 months. I wonder what would happen though if we changed up how long we got the information for. So what if we change this to 500? So that was like 6 months before. I want to see if it changes. So it showed 4x leverage max before. It's still 4x. What about if we changed it to like 200 bars? I'm just curious to see if this changes things at all, because I think we've had a lot of volatile times lately. So it's still 4. Okay, so I like that actually, because it's pretty consistently 4, and that, like right there, that tells you, I mean, it tells me at least, if I'm doing this on altcoins, don't use more than 4x leverage or else you have a chance of liquidation. But if you don't, then you probably won't get liquidated, because this is 80%, remember? 80%, so it's probably more like 5, but we're being very conservative here. Because it doesn't matter, like the leverage doesn't matter. That's like almost like a bonus in my eyes, right? Like the thing that matters is finding the winning strategy. And if it's a winning strategy, then you add in a little leverage and then you win more, or you lose more, I guess, if it's a losing strategy. But the key is to make sure it's a winning strategy and then you can use leverage. Anyways, so this is the max leverage we can use. Now what? So we paused at getting the deviation. Do this for the 4 hour instead. Okay, so we're done with that. Now we want to check our P&L close every time through. We got that. Let's go ahead and delete some of this here. So we get our P&L close every time through. So do something like this, like check all of our positions. So if we hit our target or our loss, we're good to go. get our open positions. We got our ask and our bid. I think we can start writing out the function now, or the buy and sell stuff now. So let's go ahead and figure out how we're gonna do that. Let's just walk ourselves through it with some text. So if go is true, that means that we're under the SMA, which is fine, which is good. We're under the BTC 4-hour SMA, to be specific. So all our buying functions will be in here. But if it doesn't, if go is not true, then BTC is over the SMA, so we're not running the short bot. I think we place bids, or asks, I guess, since it's short. Place asks at the, or above, right above, well, maybe not right above, above the 4-hour SMA of symbol. By, let's just say, let's go ahead and see how high it gets. It's a 4-hour, again, I'm not saying this is for ADA or anything. 9%, 10%, okay, so here is 2%, 4-5%, here is 2%. I'm gonna do it with, perk above equals, I'm just gonna do 5 for now, so it's not gonna trade very much. It would catch that one. It would catch this one. So May 16th, May 23rd. So 5 might be aggressive, but safe. And that's what matters. Like, I don't care if it trades a million times a day, as long as it's profitable. I don't care if it trades 4 times a year. This can be changed though. I'm gonna have perk above that for now. Bye. Perk above. So we place the ask above the 4-hour, so grab the 4-hour. Grab the 4-hour SMA. And grab the last 4-hour. Grab the last 4-hour SMA. And do math for perk above. Okay, so we gotta do that stuff. And we want to looks like we just hit our profit target on one of our bots right here. That's pretty cool. So that's why we're building this P&L close. We already built the P&L close, but it goes through and says, hey, you know, have we hit our target? In this case, we have hit our target, 9%. Matter of fact, it was 10%, so now it's trying to close it. So that's what this P&L close does. I just grab it from my nice functions too. There's a video showing all the nice function stuff. And if you can't find it, just join the bootcamp and you can get all the code there. Perk above. So let's go ahead and we have to get in position. I think we've already got it. I'm gonna get rid of this data frame. Actually, I'm not gonna get rid of it. I'm just gonna put it down here, because we might need it later. So, P&L close, we have that. Open positions. Pause to get that. So it's gonna loop through all this code every time, which is good because but now we need the current size in position. Okay, we need, if in position is false, let's go ahead down here and say if equals false, because we only want to run this if it's false. Print time to submit a cell. We have no position. Okay, so if in position is false, we'll submit the cell, aka the short. So we have current size. We don't need that for that. Last SMA 4 hour, we need this. So it'd be last SMA 4 hour times 1%. Let's change this to a percentage so it's a little easier. 1 plus perk above, right? So plus, so this would be 1.05, right? And then we multiply it by the last SMA, which is the last SMA that we got. So it's the last one in the data frame. So that big old data frame you saw earlier. Looks like our bot's going nuts right now, ordering a couple, making a couple orders. Again, this is for a different strategy I went over in a different video. I like it as motivation to kind of look at while I'm building. It's like, oh, look what you can build. So we got 4 active orders, which is cool. Looks like, yeah, sorry, I'm being distracted. So we get the last SMA. This would be the sell price. Sell price equals that. We'll just do 1 sell price. This is something we'll have to test, you know. 5%, is that too high, is it too low? I like it for now. Looks like we're reversing on a lot of things right now for our mean reversion. So we're submitting a bunch of orders, and that makes sense because bounced up and then it's coming back down. All that mean reversion, this that trade 75 tickers is all in the bootcamp as well. So you can get that or just check out my other videos, either one, but it's going crazy right now. So hopefully it does well. So the sell price is 5% above the last SMA. So I wouldn't want to cancel all orders. Phemex.cancel all open orders for the symbol, right? Because we don't want to have double orders. Phemex.cancel all orders. And then do we just submit the orders now? Seems a little too easy. I'm skeptical when it's too easy, you know? Let's go ahead and I'm just gonna do it and then we can come back to it. Phemex.create. I feel like we're missing something that I even wrote earlier. Symbol position size. And this should be a sell order actually, but because we're only shorting in this case. Position size, what else? The price, we need to put in the price, sell price. And then the params, which I don't think we have yet. But these params are super important for me, at least. When I'm trading, I like to use these params because it makes it so it just doesn't submit the order if I can't get a limit order. If I can't get a limit order, I pretty much don't want to submit the order. So params, I believe it's time in force and then post only. So if you're not familiar with post only order, it's just what I said. It looks like we hit our profit target on one of our mean reversion bots, which is awesome. That was fast. Already took the close and closed it. Perfect. Not the same bot we're building here, just to keep reminding you, but it's just fun to watch while I'm building because, hey, it keeps me motivated. Like, hey, you know, this bot's doing well over here. Well, if you keep building, guess what? is going to do better tomorrow, and your next bot is going to do better because it all builds off each other, which is so awesome. So now I have the params. I have all the information that's needed to make this order. Let's go ahead and open this up a little bit more. Can't quite see it all, huh? That's too bad. How do you do this? Like that, right? There we go. For your viewing pleasure. I never do that, but. Okay, so let's put print F for symbol. We just placed a cell at wherever we placed it. So sell price. Okay, I like that. Now sleeping. Can I do that again? Now going night night for how long do we want to do this? 60? 2 minutes. To fill. And then we'll do time. Time.sleep. And then we'll do 2 minutes. So if in position equals false, if in position equals false, then we're gonna do it. We're gonna make the orders, right? And then else, I guess we don't need this else, but else print, we are already in position. No orders needed. Okay, I like that. And essentially what's gonna happen with this code now, if we think about it, is we're gonna run this bot every whatever. Oh my goodness, this is going nuts actually. Look at this, 14 orders. Could be good, could be bad. It's gonna go through here, get all the information needed, run it one time, and then check to see, you know, our profit loss first and foremost, because we wanna, if we're in a position, then check the profit and loss, you know? And do what you're doing like on this bot. And if it's profitable, if we've hit our target, get us out of there. But if we've also hit our stop loss, get us out of there. You know, I don't use an actual stop loss, but this is how I do my stop losses. So it gets us out of there. And then if go equals true, and we set go to true up here, I believe. Let's check it out and make sure. Yeah, if signal equals sell, which means on the 4 hour, the price is under USD. You see how this is all kind of like coming together based off of the last videos and the last videos? That's what I love about algo trading, is like you do the hard work and then it's there forever. You just copy paste code, or you like call into your nice functions. I have two nice functions files. One's nice functions one, one's nice functions two. So it's gonna go through here. If go is true, meaning that it Bitcoin specifically is under the SMA, meaning the whole market is going in a bearish-er trend, then we run it. If Bitcoin, specifically Bitcoin, is above the 4-hour SMA, then it's a bullish trend short-term. And I don't want to do any of it. So I just say, hey, BTC is over the SMA, so I'm not running the short bot. But then it goes in here. If it's true, it sets the percentage above. I'm actually going to move this because I want it up at the top with all my other like variables I'm changing. Perk above. And then, so let's get back in there. I'm just talking us through this to make sure it's all set up. So it would get the perk above. And then if in position is false, and we got our in position over here on the first part of this video, which should be, if you're seeing this video, that video is definitely live. We get in position by doing this thing over here. See it real quick. And if that is false, meaning we're not in position, then we'll set the sell price, would be the last SMA at 20, right? And the last SMA 20 we got here, Let's double check that that is for, yep, that is, that's for the asset. You know, we have two data frames, right? We have one for Bitcoin that kind of gives us a general market vibe, and then the other one for the actual symbol that will trade. I don't even know what it is in this case, but there's two different data frames, so I just wanted to make sure that's correct. We get that last SMA, and then let's say the price is like 1,000. What is that? Why did that turn white? Never seen that before. If it's 1,000, then we'd multiply it by 1.05 or 5, because this is the percentage above, which is 0.05 plus 1, so 1.05 multiplied by the last SMA. So the last SMA, we already saw that. So that's going to put us higher, right? And then it's going to cancel all orders for that symbol, just in case there's any orders still chilling there. Ah, I need to do that. If in position equals false. No, I don't need to do that. I was going to say if position size is under. I might need to do that. Let me think about it. If position size is under, do we need to do that? What I'm trying to think is, like, what if current size is, I think we do that as well, actually. So I'm glad we walked through this, because that's how you figure things out, what you need still. Current size is under position size. And the reason we want to do that is, why do we want to do that? Oh, because there might be some open orders. So now we're saying if in position is false and our current size, I don't know if we needed that, but hey, that's a double. Now we're double checking that we're not in a position, right? So that's good for us. And then it cancels all the orders. And then it puts in the symbol to the create limit sell order, because we're shorted. The symbol, the position size, which we have at the top. And then the sell price, which we made right here. And then the params, which allow us to not enter an order if the it's not going to be a limit order, which I really love. And then it's going to sleep. And then it's going to print, and then it's going to chill, and it's just going to loop, right? So let's go ahead and see here if I just want to walk through it one more time. Because I'm trying to think, like, okay, what if we're in a losing position right now? If we're like, our position's down 20%. Well, it's gonna go through here, figure all this out, right? And then it's gonna hit the P&L close, and it's gonna see our max loss has been hit, so it's gonna kill us. Get us out of the position. It's gonna kill the position. Perfect. Now, what if we go through and we see we're up 50%? Well, it's also gonna get us out of the position at that P&L close. But what if it goes through and we're up 5%? Well, it's gonna go through here and it's gonna say, oh, well, go is true. Okay, well, oh shoot, but we're in position. So we're already in position, no orders needed. But what if we're not in position? Okay, well, it goes through here, it grabs the P&L close, not in position, so it keeps going. And Bitcoin is actually above, this is false, go is false. So it's just gonna print this. But if we are not in position and go is true, then it's going to go in here, it's going to say if in position is false, so it's going to check that, and then current size, obviously zero, would be under position size. Then we say, okay, time to submit a sell, because we have no position. And then it will get the sell price by doing that little math, canceling all open orders. Then it will print, boom, it will actually make the order, and then do it, and then keep rolling. Sleep for 2 minutes. I think this is ready. So I want to try it first off. So we got to set this up in order to actually run every 5 seconds for now. So let's say schedule dot every 5 seconds. I'm gonna change that probably to like 30 seconds or so. Dot do and bot. And then I wanna say while true, try that, what I just built, schedule.runPending. Except print maybe an internet problem. Code failed. Sleeping 10. Time dot sleep 10 seconds. Okay, let's see how this works now. So if I run this, it should start running the bot. I'm a little worried because I have this bot running and you can see it's like doing a ton of symbols. I want to make sure I'm doing a symbol that's not on this list because these are a bunch of open orders that this bot. I'm still testing this bot. That's why I'm using small position sizes, but okay. So let's see what symbol we used last. Okay, dot is dot on here because these will fight each other. Regardless, I bet they're gonna fight, but let's see what happens. I can just turn off this bot pretty easily here. So I just don't like turning them off because it just obstructs the data and all that good stuff. And then also, probably more importantly, it needs to monitor the position. So while this mean reversion bot is running, let's see if we can run this one as well. By the way, I know I flew through the second part of the video, so if you have any questions, please let me know below. I'm gonna run this now. Questions, let me know below. I'm here to demystify this industry. Like, I didn't know how to code before, but I knew that I could remove emotions from coding, so I learned how to code. So, like, if... Okay, it's running. Oh, so it submitted the sell order for a dot. Let's go ahead and see where, though. What I was saying is, like, if you need this code right now, then just jump into the bootcamp because that's where all of the code lies. Just sits there and waits. So this says it just put an order in for dot at, for one symbol. Didn't it? Dot just placed open positions, not in there. I don't see it on my list, or do I see it on dot? So refresh that. No data. No active orders now. What are you talking about? All right, looks like we have a little lag here on phemex. They never have lag. Gala looks like we're about to get stopped out, but that's fine. We just had a couple winning positions. Where is that dot position at? Says we just made a sell. We have no position, so we made a sell order. Looks like we're closing out of this order. I've got a little too much leverage on these, on this mean reversion. I'm using 10x when we just saw that we should only use 4. Let's watch this again. Dot sell. Dang, this would be super helpful if we could see our actual active orders right now, but phemex is dropping the ball live on camera. Phemex, if you're watching this, come on, what's going on? Let's check out our order history. Okay, so the dot says it's there. It says it's new. So, excuse me. I actually don't want to show that leverage again. Okay, so theoretically this worked. 10.16 would be 10.16. I don't know why it doesn't show, but it shows here on this order, 10.165. So this is working. But now I want to stress test it. How am I going to do that? I'm going to short that or long it. Doesn't matter. Don't care. I want to short it or whatever. So we fully filled. So we should have open position of dot negative one. And the next time this goes through, it should tell us our P&L. And then it should tell us some other information that like we are already in position, no orders needed. So let's wait for that to go through. See what happens. Is it running? Nope, not yet. So cool. Well, while we're waiting for that, let's see what's going on here. You can see our P&L from our mean reversion bot is actually picking up our dot P&L, which is at 0.31, which is cool. If you want the code for this mean reversion bot or this bot that I'm building here on video right now, oh, here it is. It's all in the bootcamp. Okay, dot is at 5.14% P&L. The math is gonna be a little different than here, but 5.26, that's good. I have a bunch of stuff here. Okay, so we are already in position, no orders needed. Okay, so this is working. I'm gonna change this to go every, I'll do that after the video because we might wanna run this a few more times and I don't want that to sit there for too long. I'm gonna market this. I don't need it anymore. That wasn't a real position that my bot put in. That was a position I put in. So what do I want to do now? There's a couple more things we need to do. Okay, yes, I know what we need to do. We need to get rid of all these print statements. Not all of them. I like the print of my text. I don't like the print of the DFs. Max leverage, probably don't need that. I think there's another DF around here. I just want to make sure my console is super clean. But hey, if you appreciate this transparency, like I'm literally showing you everything I know about how to build this bot right now, and I'm doing it live with you. If you appreciate that, go ahead and tap the like button because I don't know many other people that are going to show you the full step-by-step process like this. For dot, we just placed a sell order at 10.16. I wish it showed up here. I don't know why it doesn't. Maybe if I put an hour, 6 hour. It's just phemex is lagging right now. It should say I have a position because it's reading it from the API. So I guess that's good. But for some reason, maybe I'm just overloading their system or something. Don't show me that one again. Oh man. Well, I guess we'll never see that again. It's too bad. I didn't know it clicked both of them. I'll have to figure out how to redo that because I liked when the open orders would show, but I didn't like when the, I didn't like seeing the leverage changed. So maybe I can reset that somehow. But yeah, this bot is active now, and I think it got rid of all the data frames. Do we need any of this information? Starting indies, that's fine. It's fine. It's fine. It's fine. Okay, well, this bot is jamming now. If you appreciate all this transparency, go ahead and tap the like button. It pretty much tells me, hey, just keep building these publicly opposed to building them alone and not sharing like everybody else does. I swear this is probably the most secretive industry I've ever seen in my entire life. So as a kid who grew up learning everything on the internet, it's like my time to give back a bit and share this most secretive industry in the world. So now we know how to build our Ponzi bot. So I think the next thing I want to do here is I want to make this work for another exchange. So this works for phemex. This works for phemex. But now I want to get it to work for KuCoin. So let's do that. Let's go ahead and make this work for KuCoin. I know this video is probably getting kind of long, so I'll just wrap it here. And I invite you to join the bootcamp, because I'll have that code for KuCoin and phemex up there on this exact bot by the time you watch this video. So I encourage you to join that. If you just want all the code, it will be there. And then of course I walk you through exactly everything I know about algo trading that, you know, I try to share as much as possible here on YouTube, but there's some really great things in that bootcamp that I teach that I'm just not going to teach here. I can't show everything on YouTube. Can't show my full hand. I do show like a majority of it though here. So if you do appreciate that transparency, you go ahead and just tap that like button. And subscribe if you do feel inclined to see more of this. I think that's how the YouTube algorithm works, is you subscribe, you see more of the videos. You can see my bots working over here, buying, selling. I think it's mostly selling. Yeah, sell to open. This is the mean reversion, also in the bootcamp. I appreciate your time today. Feel free to ask any questions you do have in the comment section below. If you're not ready for the bootcamp, I'll post another video on the screen. I'll post that video on the screen right now so we can just keep on jamming. I'll see you in that one in about 2 seconds. Click that video and let's keep going.